Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. My name is Matthew, as you know, and today I'm going to be reacting to the Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse official trailer number 2. Y'all, I might put a video on screen, but I was literally in bed procrastinating falling asleep because I feel like I can't fall asleep unless I'm dead tired, and I was scrolling through TikTok and saw that this trailer's out.
Across the Spider-Verse trailer just came out. I have to get out of bed and make a video.
And I literally got out of bed and was like, I'm recording a video right now. And I have class at 9 a.m. But I was like, you know what? F it. I'm going to go ahead and record just so that I can, like, I don't know. I might literally edit at university. I might do that straight up. Y'all, I am very curious to see the Spider... Well, I guess you would say the animated Sony Spider-Verse become a thing, because really there's only one entry in it right now, and there's rumors it'll tie into the MCU, so that's, to be honest, what I'm most excited to see. When I was 14, Call of Duty Ghosts came out, and that was kind of my first introduction to rap music. I wouldn't normally say that rap is the kind of art I'm into. Eminem's song in Call of Duty Ghosts, as well as the inclusion of Snoop Dogg, were my first introductions to a new kind of music, and I really liked that. So what was really cool about when the first movie was coming out was my friend Joey was super excited, and he was telling me it'll be the exclusive first drop of Post Malone's new songs. At the time, I didn't know who that was, and I ended up loving it and then becoming a fan of Post Malone because of Into the Spider-Verse. And then, you know, I'm more of, I guess you could say, into country or metal. And then, after I'm getting more and more into Post Malone, I see that Post Malone, as a fundraiser with Matthew McConaughey, did some country songs. So I was like, what? What? So he did both. So I just have some fond memories that this movie has given me. It's gotten me into a new art form, and hopefully it does connect to the MCU. I'm excited to see that. I want to thank you all so much for the support on the recent videos, the reviews, Dying Light 2, all the other stuff. The next two videos will be a Secret Invasion reaction video and a Mandalorian Season 3 Episode 6 review, so hit the bell if you want to stay notified for those. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Okay.
My name is Miles Morales. I'm Brooklyn's one and only Spider-Man. And things are going great.
Oh yeah, you were supposed to be here at 5.
All right, whatever.
Whatever?
Wow.
Whatever?
So are you like a cow or a Dalmatian?
I am the spot.
It's not funny.
Don't do that.
Miles' grades are pretty good. A in AP Physics.
That's my little man.
And a B in Spanish.
What? Ooh, okay. Miles.
Are you trying to...
Mira, es imposible.
Bruh. I gotta go. All right, bye.
He's lying to you, and I think you know it.
What's up, danger?
Miles!
Wanna get out of here?
Oh! When? So wait a minute. There's an elite crew with all the best spider people in it?
Yo, who's she's pregnant. New guy?
This is unbelievable.
This is the lobby.
Miguel O'Hara.
The whole thing was his idea.
What's a guy gotta do to join this spider team?
You can never be part of this.
Don't even get me started on Doctor Strange and the little nerd.
What?
1999-99.
What?
Come on, go easy. He had a terrible teacher.
Peter.
Miles.
Mayday.
Yo. Yo.
No puedo más. No puedo más. I'll take it from here. Miles, being Spider-Man is a sacrifice.
Yo.
You have a choice between saving one person and saving every world.
Send me home.
I can't do that.
I can do both! Spider-Man, always!
Not always.
What about Uncle Ben?
If not for Uncle Ben, most of us wouldn't be here.
Damn.
Can't stop me now!
On the run!
Run forever, kid!
I can't lose one more friend.
Miguel, this isn't what we talked about!
You knew?
I had no idea what you're doing!
Everyone keeps telling me how my story is supposed to go. I'm gonna do my own thing.
Oh my god.
All stations, stop Spider-Man.
Yo, what? Yo! Oh my god.
I looked at my uncle and...
Let me guess. He died.
Yo! Looks so good. Oh, I was not expecting that. I was not ready. I was not ready for that. That actually looks so good. Holy shit, ladies and gentlemen. The first thing I gotta say, y'all, is I think this trailer is playing this villain Spot as a goofy comedic character, but I'm making a theory here. I think that Spot, I think he's the main villain anyways, so I will say this. I think that he is trying to lower Miles' guard and just test him out and see how tough of a Spider-Man he really is. I think Spot is going to end up being way more dangerous than Miles initially thinks. This scene is obviously just Gwen inviting Miles to go to the Spider-Verse or the realm or wherever they are for the first time. They probably hadn't seen each other in a year or so since the ending of the first movie. I'll also say, y'all, I don't know much about Spider-Punk, but from what I know about this movie is Spider-Punk will have gifted Gwen a pair of sneakers in this movie, and it'll be making Miles kind of jealous. That'll kind of serve as like our love triangle, I guess you could say, of this movie. Ladies and gentlemen, I will talk in detail about Spider-Man 2099 theories. I have to say, first of all, though, when I was a little kid, my cousin let me have Spider-Man character encyclopedia, and it's just a book with like 130 different Spider-Man characters and their bios. And I watched all those Spider-Man cartoons when I was a kid, but Spider-Man 2099 was never in any of those. But he was in the book, because he's in the encyclopedia, because he's from the comics. Ever since I was a little kid, I've always thought it would be badass to see Spider-Man 2099. And I'm excited to see him, but I don't think he's going to be the nicest guy.
Miguel O'Hara.
The whole thing was his idea.
What's a guy gotta do to join this spider team?
You can never be part of this.
Don't even get me started on Doctor Strange and the little nerd back on Earth 199999.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I got what I want. Spider-Man 2099 directly references the events of Spider-Man No Way Home. Honestly, this movie might have more to do with the No Way Home fallout than Doctor Strange 2 did. I'm so excited for this, y'all. I'm just trying not to scream. I don't want to wake anyone up. I say that even though I just, like, screamed super, super loud. Man, you guys, I just am so interested to see what they do with this. I can't even form a thought right now. My mind is racing. So, I believe Miles does something to piss off all the Spider-Men, especially Spider-Man 2099. I think what that is Spider-Man 2099 believes, and so do many of the other Spider-Men and women, my dad, and pigs, and robots. Very, very many of them, at least 90%, I would say, have had a very important person in their life die. That is a big part of them learning to have the responsibility to be Spider-Men. And I think Spider-Man 2099 is a big advocate of that has to happen, the sacrifice of one life in each of their lives for them to truly understand the importance of their role, be truly mature, be truly responsible, to be the best Spider-Man for their universe. So what I think is really effed up, we see a clip of Miles' father falling. If you remember in the Spider-Man video game Sony did recently in the past 5 years, Miles' father dies saving Peter Parker, Spider-Man. So I think what Spider-Man 2099 is insinuating is he needs, it believes, and wants Miles' father to die so that Miles can truly be a great Spider-Man. And it's this really effed up mindset that he has about it. And then that's when, I'll put it on screen here, but when Miles realizes Spider-Man 2099's plan, he freezes and he dips the hell out. And I think that's when all the other Spider-Men are going to be chasing him down, because they can't let him go back to his reality and warn his father, maybe because it'll warp with reality or time or what they believe should happen in his universe. And then you also get the clip of Miles saying he can do both things, and I think he's implying he can save his family and be a responsible Spider-Man.
Can't stop me now!
You can't run forever, kid!
I can't lose one more friend.
Miguel, this isn't what we talked about!
You knew?
has no idea what you're doing!
Everyone keeps telling me how my story is supposed to go. Nah, I'm gonna do my own thing.
All stations, stop Spider-Man!
Then we also have this snippet where Spider-Man 2099 is fighting Miles, and Miles says, "You knew?" So this makes me think, y'all, that Miles' dad really could die in this movie. I think there's been a lot of animated movies that haven't done a great job of connecting with an adult and a kid audience. I'm kind of getting on a tangent here, but How to Train Your Dragon trilogy and the Kung Fu Panda trilogy, I think, are great examples of cartoons that have connected with kids and adults. And I think that this movie stands a good chance of doing the same thing by having some serious tone stuff to it. So I really do think that Miles' father could die. And in this scene when they're fighting, Miles is saying, "You knew, like, you knew this would happen, or you knew this needed to happen." Maybe Spider-Man 2099 makes it happen. Maybe it's his fault. We shall see. Also, y'all, this is really cool, really unexpected, because we've never seen a Spider-Man have this happen, but Peter B. Parker Spider-Man serves as the introduction to Mayday Parker. Mayday Parker is also in my Spider-Man encyclopedia my cousin gave to me when I was a kid. And honestly, I just, again, y'all, that I haven't talked really about why I love Spider-Man, but that was a big part of it, really. I have my cousin to thank. Him coming out of his youth allowed me to embrace mine, in a way. With that encyclopedia, it really served as a big part of my introduction to this character. And it was really cool. And part of the encyclopedia was Mayday Parker. And in that book, it was at least the version of her they talk about from the comics. Peter Parker and Mary Jane have a kid who doesn't have, evidently, any powers. But then they're at Mayday Parker's high school basketball game, and she jumps from about half court and dunks the ball. And you get to just see Mary and Peter's faces just shocked in the bleachers. And that was such an iconic way to discover her powers, I feel like. This, I think, will be different because we get to see Mayday as a baby, but I just think it's sweet. I think a big complaint about Spider-Man comics, I haven't had the pleasure, really, of reading a lot of Spider-Man comics, but I've seen online tons of fans saying that Peter needs to get a happy ending for once. I think it's sweet that Peter B. Parker has a daughter and got that happy ending with Mary Jane. Hopefully he lives. Also, y'all, Scarlet Spider was in the cyclopedia. I cannot speak. What the hell is a cyclopedia? This was one of the Spider-Man that I, as a kid, just read that encyclopedia and was like, "Scarlet Spider's the shit!" Even though, like, he's not in any of the animated projects I watched as a kid. But I was just like, he's the shit! He's the absolute goat! I'm ready to see him. It might just be a cameo, but I'm excited for that. What I think is going to be really compelling about this movie, y'all, we only get to see Spot in the beginning, and I'm calling it, Spot is going to be very important, very evil. He was just testing Miles. But we also get to see Peter B. Parker agrees with Spider-Man 2099 in some ways, because he obviously lost his Uncle Ben. They might be implying he lost Mary Jane too and is alone with their daughter, but I hope that's not the case. Again, what makes the best villains is that you can identify with their beliefs in some way, or at least understand where they're coming from. I think they're going to be doing that with Spider-Man 2099 and maybe Spot as well. There's rumors that we could get a scene of Tom Holland, Andrew Garfield, and Tobey Maguire Spider-Man all together. Imagine they're chasing Miles too. Could just be a little tag scene of them though. But we also got in No Way Home, Andrew Garfield Spider-Man saying that we should do this again, you know, getting together. So maybe we'll get a little bit of payoff of that. But ladies and gentlemen, I obviously, y'all saw that I didn't do a trailer react for the first trailer for this. I think I was just too stressed with school and university, and I think I just casually watched it on my own. But this seriously increased my excitement for this movie. It was just kind of not even on my radar. This looks really awesome. One thing I guess I could say I'm technically disappointed about is, as a child reading that encyclopedia book, I was always super hyped up about Spider-Man 2099, and it seems like they're gonna make him a jerk, which I think will still be interesting, but it's definitely not what I expected. So ladies and gentlemen, hit the bell if y'all want to stay notified for the future react videos and reviews I'll be doing this coming week. I'll also be doing a Jedi Survivor playthrough in May. I'm really excited for this, y'all. I genuinely, wow. This, seriously, my expectations were blown out of the park. I was just kind of mediocre about it. This is gonna be great. Like the video if you guys like the video. Sub to the channel if you haven't subbed to the channel and you feel like you should maybe sub to the channel. And I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace out, y'all.